It's a pretty special feeling. I was there in 2009 when John Cachero won in Val d'Isère, so you know, I thought it would be pretty fun to get another medal. Johnny, of course, wasn't there to defend his title, so I'll keep it on ice for another 2 years. You know what, I felt in control the whole way down, and a lot of times that kind of means that you're not pushing the limits enough and that you're not being really fast. So when I got down to the finish, I didn't really know what to think. But of course I saw the lead that I had, and Innerhofer was fast all week, so I thought I had a good chance to at least, you know, be competitive. I didn't know if I'd win it, but at least be in the top three maybe. But the more the run went on, the more I kind of believed that I might have had that winning run. Pretty special. I think the moment I realized it was when Didier Kuch came down. He was obviously the one I was the most afraid of, and once I beat him, I kind of was like a little bit of a relief. And after that, it was just, you know, celebrations began. All of my teammates and stuff, all the teammates that remained, I guess, were pretty ecstatic. I definitely say there's a lot more media hype, especially when I arrived in Montreal. It was pretty crazy, a couple hours. And I definitely say the media hype is a lot bigger this year. Maybe also because last year with the Crystal Globe, there was a lot of gold medals at the Olympics, so, you know, obviously the Olympics were put in front of that. I'm looking forward to Sochi, but in the near future, I just want to spend some time with the family and have some downtime, rest and recovery.